The following is an encore presentation of The Howard Stern Show.
What is that?
So much pressure. So much pressure, this job. I sweat so much I have to be recycling my own waters. Hello? This is terrible. Oh my God. Is he hurt? This is a disaster. Hold it. I'll be there right away.
Mr. Dinkins, what's wrong? Another stabbing in the subway?
No. Boris Becker got himself a blood blister on his toe. This is a tragedy.
Everybody, Larry King here. How are you, Robin? How are you?
I'm okay,
how are you,
Larry
King?
Larry's good to see you.
One of the things people always ask me is how I write that column for USA Today,
where
I just have my thoughts, and then you hear dot dot dot. Before I got my typewriter, I got to type my column for
USA
Today.
You're gonna just do a column for us here?
Whatever thought comes into my mind,
I've always been fascinated by that column, and I wondered how you did it.
Is this the Goodwill Games, or am I confused?
The Goodwill Games are over, Larry.
That's
it's
right.
Time to write a new column.
Whatever thought comes to my mind, Goodwill Games.
What are you thinking now?
Is it me, or could you land a Piper Cub on my huge heart operation scar? Look, my chest is throbbing.
You think that's really good for the column?
Picking my nose in traffic is the most fun I have.
Oh, no.
Yes. Call me a no-talent, but wasn't it a bitch coming to the blackboard with a boner? Why can't I remove that mattress tag? Cincinnati, you're on the air. Hey, Robin.
Yes?
What is it about a junior high school girl in a Catholic school outfit that makes me want to wear a hood and get a net?
These are your real thoughts?
Yeah. I just type them, and then I send them to USA Today.
And they buy them sight unseen.
I have the greatest job in America. I make no sense, and they pay me. Is it my imagination, or is Saturday night the longest night of the week?
What does that mean?
I don't know. It's just my thoughts. They pop into my head. Did Mrs. Brown really have a lovely daughter? The concept of stealing is basically attractive. I wrecked my TV guide many times watching Miss Kitty on Gunsmoke. Am I crazy, or is Larry King starting to look like Howard Stern? Who the hell idea was this to wear suspenders anyway? That's a good idea.
Larry, type that one in.
I can't seem to follow the plot of the Jerry Lewis telethon. What the hell's my daughter's name? I haven't seen her in so long. I'm married so many times, I'm confused. There's nothing quite as beautiful as the buttocks. The buttocks of a college quarterback.
A college quarterback, Larry?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that was writer's block for a moment. Yeah. All writers get that.
If we dug up... Oh, Jesus, I just cut one.
Oh.
How do you spell cut? If we dug up Ed Sullivan, I bet he'd smell terrible, my friend. I love to daydream about Roddy McDowell in his Caligula outfit.
Do you know anybody we might know now, Larry?
These are just the thoughts that pop into my head.
All of your references are to people who are so old.
It occurs to me I've never seen the actual footage of Vic Morrow getting his head lopped off by a helicopter.
Wow.
That's good. They'll love it over there.
Oh.
You know, occasionally I douse myself in cheap perfume and walk around my apartment in high heels.
Well, now that's interesting. Could you expand on that?
Yes, in my column. I don't expand on anything in my column. I remember the old days when Tracy Chapman used to wash her hair.
Oh.
How the hell did Howard Stern sell out the Nassau Coliseum on Long Island?
That is a good question, and nobody has the answer.
Is it just me, Or does Father Ritter have a cute butt? You know, I love my column. What the hell is this? Hey, you forgot to put the Larry King nose on me. Hey, listen, it's Saturday night, the Howard Stern Show.
Yeah.
Gary, I'm seeing that big face.
You know, people have been complaining, Gary.
Gary.
Oh, what is this?
This is a, Robin, this is a diving helmet.
You should have got to hit the window.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, the window's clear.
Window's too big.
You put this on. This weighs 70 pounds.
That is heavy.
Put that on. I'm going to get out of this, Larry. You put that on for the rest of the show. We got a lot of complaint letters, Governor.
Let's see what you look like in that one.
Hey, coming up tonight. Oh, man. Much better. That is a much... I don't know. People just don't like Gary's mouth and lips and teeth. They just don't like it. So this kind of blocks it.
Turn it around. Turn it up a little bit.
Turn it around.
Turn it around. A little bit more.
Turn it around completely.
Completely.
You can't? Maybe get it on backwards. Yeah, make it smell your own breath. Hey, anyway, tonight we got a good show. We got May Pang, got Angie Bowie, Iggy Pop, Bob Hope on the road to Iraq. It's beautiful. A lot of things coming up. Don't go away. What's happening? There's a lot of noise in here. Gary, where's your helmet?
I'm not wearing it anymore.
What?
What do you mean you're not wearing it? He says he's not wearing it anymore.
That sounds like a
mutiny to me.
It's heavy.
Hey, boy, you want to be on TV?
Not like this.
Hey, man, what's with you? Put it on. You're distracting
people.
It's
heavy. People. It really is heavy.
Well, put it on. You're distracting people, and you're going to ruin the Bob Hope piece. Robin, you're not going to believe it. I think Bob Hope is ready. There it goes. There goes the diving helmet. All right. I believe Bob Hope is ready to go to Iraq, is he not?
I think so. He's on the road again.
He certainly is. Take a look at this.
It's Rocket's red glare and the laughs are bursting in air with Bob Hope from Iraq. Join Bob and our boys for Don't Shoot Me, I'm 86 and I'll be dead in 2 weeks.
Hey, I just flew in and boy, is this camel tight.
He's the king of Kuwait comedy.
I just flew in and boy, are these broads hairy.
Bob's old.
Sinead O'Connell. That little bitch. She's not performing with me here in Egypt. Say, where are we anyway? Where's Fat Roseanne?
I'd jump on that water buffalo. I'm losing it.
Bob's hip.
Hey, is that a tank or is that Oprah?
Bob's blind.
I've got glaucoma. God, I can't see the lines. Could you move that billboard a little closer? Hey, I gotta tell you, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Mr. Cue Card Man, could you flip that billboard a little faster there, kid? Hey, I'll tell you, there's so much sand out here. Where's my wedgie?
And when the billboards can't cut it, the Skywriters take over.
Hey, let's bring out Jessica Hahn. Right here. Jessica, get that battleship out of your panty. These Arabs, they're holding back oil. So why don't we just tap Jerry Lewis's head? Blib, blab, pool, toot. Oh, that was a cloud I just read. Hey, who's the wise guy?
It's Bob Hope in Iraq. And don't shoot me, I'm 86 and I'll be dead in 2 weeks.
Let's hear it for Agent Orange.
It's a Bob Hope special.
Hey, where the heck is Bing?
Is he still stiff?
And the Don't Shoot Me, I'm 86 and I'll be dead in 2 weeks special.
So good night. And for perfection in vodka, whoops, sorry, wrong billboard. Ladies and gentlemen, Emmanuel Lewis, Brooke Shields, and Bill
Stanley. Here he goes. All right. Bob Hope, Iraqi special. I didn't know Bob was reading off of clouds now. Things have gotten really, that glaucoma really bad, huh?
Well, it's amazing that they can get those billboards up that fast.
Yeah, I know. It is amazing how they work that. That's TV. You should see the billboards I read off. You wouldn't believe it. I gotta tell you, it's really unbelievable, I gotta tell you. Anyway, Robin.
It's not very funny to make fun of an old man.
He doesn't really have...
can't go to Iraq.
But he doesn't really have glaucoma, does he?
Yes.
Oh, he does?
As far as I know.
Well, I didn't know that.
He has a bit of an eye problem, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, he's 86. He's lucky he can see anything. All right, you want to do some news?
Yes, but, what I was saying is, he's an old man. It's not funny to make fun of the old like that.
Something tells me I'll be making funny of the old in about 3 seconds. When Robin says that means I have to get irreverent and make a jackass out of myself. I'm pretty sure of that.
I'm not setting you up.
Yeah.
Anyway, no, Bob Hope has said he's not necessarily going to Iraq to entertain the troops, but Jay Leno
is stepping in. 2 weeks to live. How can I go to Iraq? I gotta tell you that.
Jay Leno.
Yes, he's ready to step in and take Bob's place. Yes.
Yeah, I'm going to take Bob's place. Yeah, I'm going to do that.
Of course he's going to take Bob's place. You know how much money Bob Hope, I read this in Rolling Stone, Bob Hope made off of Vietnam and stuff?
How much?
I mean, like millions. I mean, all those specials and stuff, he gets paid for that junk.
I never realized that he really, he wouldn't charge for going over to Vietnam.
No.
But he would charge NBC for the special.
That's right.
And that's how he'd make his money. So it worked out for him anyway. Well, if the troops stay there until Thanksgiving, Jay Leno will go over and do 2 shows. But he says they won't be those extravaganzas that Bob Hope used to throw. He's just going to go over there and do a few jokes.
Do you think my banana chin will make the troops hungry, Robin? Now, I gotta tell you.
Yeah, Jay Leno, that should be pretty cool.
Yeah.
My banana chin might make them hungry, though.
By the time he gets there, they'll laugh at anything, I suppose.
And no broads, ain't I a sport?
He's saying his wife, Mavis.
You guys could get hot for my wife, Mavis.
Because
he's not taking girls?
He promised her a European vacation.
Yeah.
And since he's going to have to go to Iraq for Thanksgiving, he says, I'll take you along with me, babe.
Yeah, oh, very nice. That's very nice.
Meanwhile, Howard, there's a lot of anxiety and people are feeling as if they can't do anything.
Tell me about it.
About this whole Iraqi situation.
Oh,
it's
Iraq.
Like our hands are tied. What are you talking about?
I thought you meant this TV show.
No.
My hands feel real tied.
Crisis.
I know.
But, we are ingenious here in the United States. So what are we doing to get out of all of that aggression?
What are we doing?
In Des Moines.
Yes.
People are, those people who play with the paint guns?
Yes.
They're now shooting at targets of Saddam Hussein.
Oh, really?
To get out their aggression. Let's roll the tape.
What a bunch of babies.
Here they go out in the woods.
Survivalists.
For a buck, you just have fun, have a good time, and the money goes to big brothers and big sisters.
All right.
See, now it's all better. They just shoot at the picture of Saddam with their paint guns, and everything's just fine.
Do that to Jay Leno. Get a picture of him.
I gotta tell you, boy, these groups are really mean. They want to see girls. They don't want to hear jokes.
Those people are very brave, They're upset with Saddam Hussein, so they get a paint gun and they shoot at a picture of him. Why don't they go over there?
Yeah,
they're so upset.
Country. Yeah.
Go get him. You're so upset.
I tell you. Hey, we're going to come back. We got some MTV tapes in the news and stuff. Okay, still doing some news here.
That's right, it was MTV Awards Week. Did you watch the program?
No, I was asleep because I have such an exciting life between my radio show and my TV show.
Well, then I brought you some highlights. Good job. Arsenio Hall is the big host of the program.
Right.
So let's take a look at his hosting abilities.
Here we go.
Good to see you all. I know every year I say this, but this is the show right here, okay?
Nice
outfit. Yes. Bigger than any other year, this is the year. Forget the Grammys, forget the American Music Awards. That's Foreplay. Tonight, climax, baby.
Baby.
Performing live, one of the hottest hard rock bands in this particular galaxy. Ladies and gentlemen, Motley Crue.
Wait a second. Wait a second. My new look. My new look. My posse. My posse. Why does MTV have this guy? How did he get to be a star? Why aren't I successful?
Why don't you loop that through your...
Through my ear? You like it like this?
Through the earpiece that goes around your ear.
Oh, you like it like that?
I think it'll stay on a little better.
I want to be just like Arsenio.
Yeah, that's how his was.
What a loser. It's hard to get that whole... I never had any respect for Arsenio, but I'll tell you something. It's not easy getting this whole look together, I'll be honest with you.
You see?
If some, if you like it, you gotta go for
it. You look like a rabbi. I don't know why.
So does Arsenio. And what do? You just sort of like...
No, it was just sort of looped under
hanging.
His chin.
Hanging? Like
yeah,
it like
yeah.
that?
Yeah, there you go. Give me some of these. Yeah.
My energy. I don't know. I need my posse.
Yeah, well, he didn't have his posse last night.
It's appropriate that a show which is being seen live around the world from Japan to Uruguay. Why did they have to choose that? Because I can't say Uruguay. Uruguay. Should have a truly international cast. Ladies and gentlemen, that cute little lady with the bald head, Sinead O'Connor. Go, baby, go!
Oh, yeah. I'm sure she didn't want to sing this song either. Hey, my chain's falling off. What do you, I bet you getting Sinead O'Connor to do, MTV puts a lot of pressure on, MTV puts a lot of pressure on, nothing compares to her head, Sinead O'Connor. I'll be honest with you.
Look at her dance. Look at the outfit she had on.
Oh,
she really dressed up.
The boots and the dancing is so erotic.
Oh,
Hare Krishna! Hare Krishna! Somebody stick up. Somebody vomit in her mouth.
All right, this is Belle Biv DeVoe, part of the new edition.
Hey, what's he grabbing there, dude?
Yeah, they got kind of obscene.
Yeah. Move along with
another reunion. Susan
big reunion.
Day and David Cassidy.
Come on, get happy.
Yeah.
Now, is what we're bringing. Come on, get happy.
Oh, eat
I
me.
I thought he hated that song.
Oh, yeah, what is that?
I thought he hated that whole image.
Where's Arsenio to pick things up? Dude, excellent. Smack both of those two idiots. Yeah.
First of all, we'd like to thank God above.
Now, who's
most
that?
Most of all.
Oh, Janet Jackson.
I'd like to thank God.
And I'd like to thank Mr. God.
Hey, at least she's got respect, Mr. God.
Mr. God. Everybody else was using just the one name.
Why does everybody thank God? For
I
a
don't
song
know.
They wrote. I don't understand.
Especially rappers. Why do they thank God?
I don't understand why they... because, believe me, rappers shouldn't be thanking God, because, quite frankly, that's not music. God didn't help them at all. I don't get it myself.
And then, of course, Madonna. She was one of the last performers on the show, and she outdid herself.
I see. Hey, whoa, wait a second. Let's rewind there for a second. What the hell is going on? Whoa, wait a second. Let me see that in slow-mo.
Whoa.
Yeah, honey. Somebody ought to smack her.
Oh, let's watch a little more. What else is she up? Oh.
Wait a second. That guy just passed out. What are you finding there? Some alligators and parrots? Or what?
What do you think he brought home?
Quicksand. That's pretty interesting. I'll
tell
you that.
The MTV Awards were something else this year.
All right, honey. Hey, let's bring out Iggy Pop. Iggy Pop, he's been around for years. I've never met Iggy Pop, actually.
No, this will be a first.
Friend of, there's Iggy. I never actually met you all the years that I've been in radio. Very nice to meet you, Iggy.
Nice to meet you.
How you doing? That's
Hi,
Robin.
There. How are you?
Good.
Iggy's mellowed. You've mellowed somewhat, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I guess so.
I think I used to be very, very afraid of you. See, Iggy used to do stuff like roll around in glass on stage,
oh.
throw himself at people, and you used to smear peanut butter on yourself and stuff.
Yeah, I did some smear.
Now, Iggy Pop is not your real name, right?
You mean my given name?
That,
no,
that's the
Jim,
name you took.
Jim Osterberg.
Jim Osterberg, so yeah. You're a Jew. Osterberg
no,
is a
no.
Jewish name.
I think it's an adopted name. My dad was adopted by a lady named Osterberg.
Oh, is that
she
what
wasn't
it is?
Even Jewish. She was Swedish.
Oh, so you're Swedish.
Well, I don't know.
No,
you
don't
know. I don't know.
Oh, he's adopted. So you were adopted by
I'm American. I'm an American.
So you're not
a
Jewish.
Little bit. No, I'm not Jewish.
We don't know what Iggy's religion is.
But, I mean, I can swing with Jews.
Nice.
You know.
And Iggy is...
I can schmingle and bingle and, you know.
Now, what happened? Because
you talk showbiz,
I like
in other
cream
words.
Cheese, yeah.
Something weird happened. We booked Angie Bowie for the show. I didn't... Now, wait a second. I didn't know even that you were at war with Angie Bowie.
I'm not at war with Angie Bowie.
I got
Bowie.
The vibe because they said, well, Biggie's
well,
mad, Angie Bowie.
I just didn't want to, no, I just didn't want to.
Because you're
you
Bowie's
know, be
friend.
Part of all that. Well, just that whole kind of thing is kind of like, you know, I mean, what's that, you know?
She's been bad rapping Bowie.
Well, just, you know, I don't know, just... If you haven't got anything to say about yourself, what's right. the point of going around telling little tales on
Bowie's
other people?
Sounds like Bowie
I
got him in the divorce.
Yeah.
You know, when they were splitting up the friends.
I just think it's real
creepy. My friends are going through a divorce, and I'm going to tell you something. When they went through a divorce, we split up friends. And I ended up with the woman side of the thing.
I see.
You know, so that's what happens. When Bowie and Angie went through the divorce, Iggy went with Bowie. And I got to tell you, that's not an entirely stupid
move.
Good move, dude. I'm telling you right now. Oh, yeah, because Angie was backstage. I want to see Iggy. Iggy has seen my son. I haven't seen my son. I want Iggy to tell me about my son. Oh, got real vicious backstage. So, you know, it was kind of weird. It really was. It was sort of weird.
It's your show, you know.
We don't need to have these entries.
Yeah,
they
right.
seem
oh,
to
man.
Bubble up around
yeah,
them.
Yeah, right. Well, that's something. Like modern life. You know, everything's kind of disintegrating with the old family systems. Kind of
right.
kind of biting the...
Do me a favor.
Weenie.
Iggy, never mind biting the weenie.
Okay.
Do me a favor. Pick up this guitar.
You want to play something?
Let's do a... I'll give you your choice. Either do one of your songs or do a medley of some of your greatest hits.
I can do that.
You could do that?
I would rather do that.
All right. Because
all right.
a lot of people say, well, what has Iggy done? Okay. A lot of people want to know what Iggy Pop has done. Iggy, do you have any kids?
Yeah.
So you are a pop?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. I just want to know.
What, do you think that other name wasn't good for show business? I don't know why he
what,
changed
Mo
it.
Ostenberg? I think Mo Ostenberg would be a good name.
Whoa.
Hey, John Q, that's my music, all right?
Iggy, now let me ask you. Iggy, now when you say, you said you want to be a dog.
Your dog.
You want to be your dog.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
You're singing that to
a
girl?
Well, you know, it was the idea of, like, have you ever seen, like, a really good-looking girl, really nicely dressed,
right.
and she's walking down the street with her dog, right?
Right, right.
And, like, her dog is... Maybe, you know, he's intimate with her body and she likes him and everything.
Right,
and
right,
you
right,
think,
right.
you know, so you think, you know, I'm basically more than that. It's the idea of, like, I want to unite with your body. I don't want to talk about literature with you
yeah.
or something, you know. I don't want to, like, judge you as a person. I
right.
want to dog you, you
I
know. I want to
dog you.
I want to dog you. It was just a little different slant on, you know.
Wait a second. Yeah. It's Bowie on the phone.
Yeah.
He just went back with Angie. When I said you mellowed, I was wrong. Now listen, Iggy, are you going to stay here for Angie or not? That's what I want to know.
Stay where for Angie?
Are you going to stay on set when Angie comes out?
No, I didn't.
See, I don't want to lose
doing,
you.
I didn't even know she was doing this show.
I didn't even know she was doing the show.
No, I only did the show because I thought she wasn't doing the show.
Now, you're so wild. I figured you're not afraid of her.
Well, that's not the point, man. I choose my company.
Yeah,
you know,
I got
the guitar. You know,
really
I do
don't
what
like
I want,
her. You don't
know?
Like her.
I didn't say that.
You do like
I'm
her.
Splitting this, man. I don't need to
No. You don't have to split this.
I don't have to talk about what I don't want to talk about with you, you know?
No.
I just think the whole thing's jive, you know? I don't want to be a part of that.
Okay, that's cool.
Thing.
I understand that. Anyway. I understand. All right, okay. Take it easy. You're so muscular, I'd be afraid to tangle with you. Yeah. You know what I mean? I could tie you up and keep you here.
I'm nonviolent. So
but what about your kids? Do they live with you or they live with your other wife?
I got a boy 21, and he was in L.A.
You have a boy 21?
Yeah, he's as big as you are.
I had a boy 21 once. I choose not to talk about it. I don't kiss and tell. Listen, very few people know it. Iggy's son is Arsenio Hall.
Oh, no. I feel so sorry for you.
That's so true. Iggy's distraught over it. But anyway, I want to thank Iggy Pop for coming here. Now, what's the name of the new album, Iggy?
It's Brick by Brick.
Brick by Brick.
Yeah,
excellent album. We recommend you go buy it.
Okay.
You heard a sample of it. Now you've got to go out and buy it. That's all there is to it, all right? I want to thank Iggy Pop.
Cool.
Hey, did you have fun, Iggy?
I did.
It's good. It's good to meet you. It really is. Robin, sitting here is Angie Bowie.
That's right.
Who's my good friend who made me famous around the world when she admitted to me on Joan Rivers. When she admitted to me on Joan Rivers that, in fact, she found David Bowie, her ex-husband, in bed with Mick Jagger.
You dragged that out of her.
I dragged it out of her. And you know
what? He's going to work that.
It's one claim to fame.
He's going to work it to death.
It's so cool because it made me look good. And, you know, I read in a paper today, Angie, that David Bowie's ticket sales weren't doing so good. And after that revelation, he sold more tickets.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, we're just still all working for him.
Right.
He's doing promo, you know, and trying to help the boy along.
I thought
it was interesting that somehow you disappeared from the story.
I know. I'm not in the story anymore. They somehow now say Joan Rivers got it out of you.
Joan Rivers got that out of you.
Well, they don't say that around me because I remind them.
Now, let me introduce someone else. We'll make this like a theme show right now.
Okay.
Bring out May Pang and her husband, Tony Visconti.
Here they come.
Oh, there they are. Oh, the happy couple. All right, May. Yes. To see you. Hey, Tony.
Tony wants to kiss you, too.
Tony, want to kiss me on the lips?
I knew. He had that look in his eye.
You
got to be careful.
What's wrong with you?
I grew up in Britain.
What's the matter with you?
Rock and roll.
Now, this is good. May, really?
What?
I could see your breasts.
Oh, great.
Isn't that, that's exciting. Now, that's probably what got John Lennon. Now, Tony, you mind me talking about John Lennon with May? I mean, that's got to be a kind of a drag. I mean, you're always being compared with John Lennon, constantly.
Are you compared
with John Lennon? No, he never produced records.
No, he never produced records, but you know what I mean. In bed, sexually, the whole thing. I mean, May,
Howard's mind.
In my mind, for a woman, there is no greater thrill to be in bed with John Lennon.
Is that right?
To me, I mean, seriously. I mean, imagine May's a virgin. And you were not a virgin when you slept with John, though, were you? You had been with other men. You had been.
Yes.
What? I swear to God, this is so exciting. Poor Tony. I mean, you know, Tony's never going to get over this. It's too weird.
Poor Tony. He looks very happy to me.
Tony's totally cool.
Maybe Tony fell in love with you because you slept with John. He's sort of like, wow.
No,
wait a minute.
He was my favorite Beatle.
He was your favorite.
Yeah.
He had
all of his cards. Gave away Ringo.
Some choice. Ringo. Paul, who's now playing God knows what. Hey, you guys were with Paul McCartney last night, were you not?
Yeah, the other night.
Now, how come you get to hang out with Paul? Because you slept with John? No, isn't that the reason?
No, I think that's why, actually.
Well, no, wait a minute. Come on. Oh. They also know Tony very well. And, I mean, I met Paul years ago when I was with John.
May, for an Oriental woman, your breasts are very big.
They are.
I got to say.
Big
American breasts. I'm telling you, I can see May's chest. I can't help. Does that jacket ever come off? Seriously, do you ever wear that? Because a lot of women are into showing. I was reading the Inquirer.
Oh, were you?
A lot of women just wear their bras now out in public.
No, that's what the Inquirer says.
That's what it says.
You know his type of reading, though.
Yes, yes.
But you never wear that in public. You would never just go jacketless with your bra showing.
No.
You would not.
No.
Is that true, Tony?
Around the house, she does.
She does, okay.
Yeah,
I understand. Because a lot of women would take off the jacket.
Yeah.
Well, your breasts are very beautiful, if I may say
you.
That. And, Angie, what are you laughing at? Oh, because I didn't say your breasts are beautiful?
No, I don't
are
have
you
any
jealous?
I don't count. I don't like fried eggs.
Do you think that's
make me laugh.
But they're
start.
Very beautiful fried eggs.
Your eggs are beautiful.
Thank you so much.
No, but seriously, would you ever get breast implants?
No.
You would never get them.
Only because I wouldn't want to jiggle when I ran. But that's just personal.
What are you, an A cup, would you say?
Oh, probably triple A.
You're an A cup. You don't even wear a bra, do you, ever?
No.
May, you were so full. You have no implants?
No.
That's not a result of having a baby that you got bigger, or you were always this big?
I guess I was always this big.
Well, John was very lucky.
Actually, I started to block.
You said they grew after John.
That's right.
They grew after John.
After John.
I got the best.
John was like Jesus.
Right.
Yeah. When he would touch breasts, they would grow. It was unbelievable. It's just unreal what John could accomplish in life.
I went from 34B, and then when I got pregnant, I went to 36E.
And you maintained that?
I mean, I dropped a little.
You dropped a little? So what are you now, at a D?
E-flat.
An E-flat,
And you're full Oriental, right? You're full Chinese.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Is that correct?
Yes.
That's right. Now, let's get back to being with John Lennon. To me, as if I was a woman, to have slept with John Lennon would be the greatest thing. Tony, does she ever moan in bed, John, or anything like that?
No, she speaks Chinese, so I just...
You don't know who she's called.
Really? Because, in fact, when Mick and David were in bed, he started speaking Chinese, too?
Now, Howard, don't start with me.
I'm not going to start with you anything, my dear.
I wasn't there. I only found them on my return from the airport.
What do you think they were doing in that bed?
I think they were passed out, unconscious, drunk. But that's just... Because that's how it appeared.
Yeah.
See, that's, in all seriousness, who knows what happened? Because just the other night, I was with Bob Woodruff, our executive producer. Yeah. We both passed out drunk, naked, and found
us
in bed. And nothing was going on.
Angie didn't find you, did she?
Yeah, right.
Because she's going on Joan Rivers if she did.
Now, Tony, you say that May never brings up John in lovemaking. It's always centered on Tony. Tony Visconti, is that right?
I think so, unless she's deluding me.
Right, and she screams out in China, what'd she say? Ching, chang, yeah, oh, wang, yeah. Bang.
All those words, all
is
those
that what
words,
it,
yeah.
Bua, oh, nya, ta, yes,
ching, po.
I mean, what does it sound like?
As if you think May should be holding herself as a shrine.
But do you ever, when you're making love with May, do you ever say to yourself, my God, John and I are sharing... This vehicle.
Oh my goodness!
Do you ever say this vessel, if you will, is it's just me and John and we are sharing something? Seriously, that would go through my mind. That would go
it
through.
Has
my mind.
Actually gone
would
through.
Would that
my
inhibit
mind?
You though?
It would in a way because you should see who the slobs my wife was with. I'll tell you that because it inhibits me plenty. I'd be honored if my wife slept with someone as cool as John Lennon. No, my wife slept with bikers.
Oh dear! Who did you sleep with before your wife?
I slept with bikers. No, but seriously, now you brought some pictures along. These are, see, May always brings memorabilia along.
She has plenty of it.
Because May had a weird life. I mean, Yoko said, go be with my husband, right?
Yeah, sort of.
How was it when he held you in his arms? Was it? Did you feel his genius? Did you feel his genius surging through you like electricity, like electricity or something? Huh? What was that like? Did you feel something special? What
did
was
all
it?
Of a sudden you think you could write music or anything like that?
Well, I wish that came through.
She did, believe me. She did think she could write music.
Yeah. Here's a man. Would you look at this? This is when he was in bed. Does that look like?
Oh, look at Tony. Jesus, again, May, you're bringing out the pictures.
Yeah.
Again. Now you see that? That's John laying in bed.
Wow.
Yeah. I don't see May next to him.
No, I'm taking the photo. So how could I be next to him?
And he's saying to himself, "Can you believe this? She's taking a picture
again.
Of me in bed again.
What is he going to do with all these pictures?
All right. Well, that's proof positive, I guess. Couldn't John Lennon afford a better room? Look at his electrical
wires. I was
going to
say it's kind of a taggy little room there.
You have to remember, this is 70s. Four?
But he had money then.
He had money in 74.
No, wait a minute. It went somewhere else. It went across town.
Now, don't forget, Yoko. Now, this is John and...
Is that
and
Julian?
Oh, Julian. I thought he was with Angie Bowie. Because
Howard.
They got the same chest. Let me see that again, for God's sake.
Paralyzed sexuality. That is this man's brain.
Look like fried eggs. All right. Oh, now some proof. Oh, Tony, this must... Look at poor Tony.
Now, John has a dental dam in his mouth, so I'm
that's
just
right.
saying he's
right.
practicing safe sex.
John knew how to practice safe sex. There is a dental dam in his mouth. What happened to him over there? What is in his mouth?
That is a photo. The lens cap.
John had the lens cap in his mouth.
Yeah.
All right, and
there
Harry
it is. Nielsen.
And Harry Nielsen.
Oh, a threesome.
Yeah.
And May, were you in love with John?
Yeah.
You were in love?
Yes.
Oh, look at Tony. Oh, Jesus.
Oh,
I'm sorry,
well.
Tony.
Man.
But you're happier with Tony now because it's more normal life?
Well, I'm alive.
The words out of my mouth.
True. Tony's breathing. It's a lot better.
He's got something on, John. He's alive.
Now, May, can I ask you something? Are you nude in this picture?
No, everybody thinks that. I'm wearing a tank top.
You are wearing a tank top?
Yeah, a tube top, yeah.
And John was a great lover. Would he, let's say, if you began at 7 o'clock at night making love, would John make love to you five times in one night?
Five times in one night, Jesus. I don't know about that.
Would John ever say, you know, May, I love you so much, I'm going to give you my manliness? Five times in one night? Would he ever say that?
No, we never had conversations. We had to stop somewhere so we can watch Johnny Carson.
Oh, I see. No, but seriously, how long would John... Like, if John was in bed...
Was he a giving man?
Would John
lover?
Last for, let's sorry say, more than 3 minutes? No, seriously, I'm curious.
He was great.
Tony, I'm sorry. I don't care how long you last. It's John I care about.
I
John, damn it. Me and May, that's all we care about is John. You and your David Bowie album.
I just wondered, does she still sit around? Does she make Tony listen to the tapes?
Oh, yeah.
No.
May's got these weird tapes of John and her and stuff.
Outtakes and studio
cuts. She walks around with a cassette. Here, Tony. Listen, whenever they get in a fight, here, Tony, listen to this.
Wait a minute. I end up hearing all T-Rex tapes.
Oh, really?
David Bowie tapes.
Tony's still dreaming about T-Rex. She's dreaming about John Lennon. He's dreaming about T-Rex. Tony was the producer of the T-Rex album.
Yes.
Angie, what about David Bowie? Now, I mean, with all these rumors of bisexuality and everything, would he hold out longer in bed because he was bisexual? In other words, because
Howard.
Yes. Because seriously, I would
Yes, Howard, he did.
He did.
He was a brilliant, fabulous, aggressive, dynamic, powerful, ongoing lover.
And then he went off with some guy. You really?
That
no,
was
we
with
woke
Mick.
Up in bed with
him. Could you
that
make love to him,
Mick,
let's say, five times in one night?
I never saw enough of him to make love to him five times in one night.
You're a hell of a wife.
I used to see Angela's breasts on a regular basis.
Where did you see them?
We all lived together.
Is that right?
Yes, in an apartment in Beckenham, Kent.
You lived with David Bowie and Angela?
Yeah.
Oh, no kidding.
And my girlfriend, Liz.
Now, why do you think Bowie left her? She's a lovely woman.
She was the best thing that happened to him. I
really?
Have to say that, yeah.
You really do think that?
Yeah.
And why won't Bowie let you see your son? What is going on? You don't seem like that irresponsible. Maybe you are an irresponsible mother.
I don't know,
but you don't seem...
I'm not an irresponsible
Once you learn how to put on lipstick, he might let you back in the house. How can a man keep someone from seeing his child?
A good question.
How does he get away with that?
Well, I guess he's not going to get away with it, but it's too late now. My son's the age of majority. He's 18 and a half, you know? So now that the time of... He should be really an adult, you know?
Do you
know?
Think your son will
so
come
So it really
you?
Should be up to him, you I know? See. If he wants to see me, he's an adult. He should be able to make those choices, you know?
Well, I want to thank Angie and May for coming in here, for God's sakes. And Angie, stop bringing everyone down. Just say you see your son a lot, okay? Bumming everybody out on a Saturday night.
I'm sorry.
I said, do you want to make a personal plea right here?
Yeah, what do you think this is? Hey, David, why don't you let your wife see the kid, huh? What's the matter with you, for God's sake?
Yeah.
Huh? What's the matter with you?
Yeah.
And May, of course...
You're now a new mother.
Let me just smell your hands. I want to smell the hands that were with John Lennon. Yes, the hands that were with John Lennon. Oh, yes. All right, we'll be back right after these words. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We sent Stuttering John, our ace reporter, out into the field this week to find Eddie Murphy.
This is like going from the sublime to the ridiculous.
You went all over. You went to Eddie's house, Bubble Hill. I like that.
Why were you looking for Eddie Murphy?
Yeah, why are you looking for Eddie Murphy?
They told you to. Okay.
No, I'm a big fan of his, and I thought that I.
You're a big fan of his. Hey, let me tell you something. What happened was Eddie Murphy was in town. He was doing some. I guess all comedians go to little clubs to work out.
Yeah, he's working on a new routine.
I like how comics now, they make it like it's so difficult. They had to work out. But Eddie was working out, and we figured, hey, John, go over and hit him with some questions. He had trouble finding Eddie, but he went in search.
Okay.
All right, so let's take a look at this, all right?
Eddie and me. Hi, my name's John Melendez, and I'm standing here in front of Rockefeller Center. Why? Because this is where the man, the ultimate comedian in the world, made millions of people laugh on Saturday Night Live. You know what I'm talking about? Eddie Murphy. Eddie Murphy is my favorite all-time ultimate comedian, and I'm here...
Wait, excuse me. What is this? What are we looking at right now? What are you doing?
I didn't direct the piece.
What do you mean direct? Someone told you to stand
No, I'm... Yeah, we're... I'm prerequisiting it.
What?
I'm prerequisiting it.
Wait. What are you doing?
Listen, I was
prerequisiting it.
I'm introducing the piece.
Hey, tell everyone what college you went to. I want people to understand that a college education is totally unnecessary unless you're going to be a lawyer or a doctor.
I went to Sam Ash U.
Right. Now, where'd you go? Tell everyone.
I went to
You were prerequisiting.
You went to more than one college. I want you to give me complete
credentials. I went to Nassau Community College, where I learned all my grammar.
The 13th grade.
And then I went to NYU to work on film and TV.
You went to Iggy Pop College. Here we go.
The comedian. And I'm here in front of Rockwell Center because it just made me feel good to be with a place that made so many people laugh. I hear he's in town, and I feel this man. I bought all his movies. I bought all his videos. I have his posters in my room. I feel this man owes me an autograph. I feel that he could at least talk to me.
Wait.
They told me I'm supposed to be in pursuit of Eddie Murphy. I'm supposed to prerequisite it.
Prerequisite it.
What is it? That's when you order something. Do you know what a prerequisite
yes,
is?
Yes, I know what it is. What is
a prerequisite? Tell us now.
Well, if you got to get to 102, you got to do 101 first.
No, what is prerequisite?
Yeah, well,
what is a prerequisite?
It's something you got to do before you take the other course. It's a gradual improvement. You know,
it's something.
Whatever. Just forget it. Listen to
no, what is a prerequisite? I want to know what it is.
Play the piece.
In college, he majored in cutting T-shirts.
He's very good at it.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Very nice. What is a prerequisite?
Well, if you want to get into biology 102, you got to take biology 101. And so,
you can't answer the
question. That's a prerequisite.
That's college.
Come on with me as I try and search down Eddie Murphy.
Search down Eddie Murphy.
Eddie. Oh, sorry.
Wrong guy.
Eddie. Oh, sorry. I thought you Eddie Murphy. You know, one of these guys is going to get real pissed. Hi, I'm here in front of Paramount. You know, the movie company that he's been coming out with these great movies there. I hear they're really nice people, so we're going to go in there and talk to them. So maybe Eddie's having one of his power lunches. Yeah, hi, how you doing? Just looking for the Paramount executive offices.
I'm going to shut that light, please. That's not allowed in here. Shut it off now.
So what should I do?
Shut it off.
Ooh.
And shut that off.
Is this off?
Yeah.
I'd like to go up to see the executives.
You have an appointment with them?
No, I'd like to.
Out of the building then.
We can't just talk to someone?
No, you can't.
No possible way?
No possible way whatsoever. You have to leave the building.
Hey, this is Roger and me.
I'm telling you.
Hey, this is getting good now.
Yeah, I told him, man.
This is Roger and me.
Yeah.
That dude didn't like you.
Shut that off. Shut off that light.
Come to think of it, we don't like
him. Jackie don't like him, that's for sure.
Yeah, I'm not imitating the guy. I want you to shut off the lights.
Yeah, shut off the lights in here. I'm ready to go.
This is Eddie's house.
This is Eddie's house.
Yeah, I'm here to see Eddie. Could I get a word with him?
He's not in.
Well, can I speak to you for a second, sir?
No, I cannot come out there to get and talk to you.
Excuse me?
No, I'm not allowed to come out there and talk to you.
Can I talk to you here?
What is it that you want to know?
Well, I'm actually an old friend of Eddie. I'm from the island. I'm from Long Island.
Yeah.
And I've been searching down Eddie now for a while now. If he would just see me, I'm sure he would know who I am.
Well, Eddie's not home right now, and I cannot give you any kind of information of where about he is.
It's like he's talking to a midget fireplace. What is that?
How do we know he's anywhere? He can be talking to anything and have somebody on the other side of that wall.
And both of them speak English equally well. And John's the man with the college education.
That's why I get nervous in front of you. That's the only reason.
Right.
Give me a paper, I'll write my stuff down.
All right, Mr. Prerequisite.
I gotta, you know. Do you think that Arsenio's a bigger star than him?
Well, I cannot answer that question, sir.
Well,
running out of questions.
Did you,
Sir, throw him.
You know, what do you think of the Howard Stern show?
Well, is this starring John? I'm sorry, I'm not allowed to say anything about. Oh, I cannot comment on anything.
All right, let me just.
How do you know it was you?
I'm gonna leave, but let me just. Could you tell Eddie I was here to see him?
Was here to see
him. Tell him I bought all his movies. I have all his posters. I've been a big fan of his for years. I see him in the comedy shops on Long Island, and I'm just a little bit upset that he won't. I've been trying to get an interview with him for like weeks now. Could you tell him I'm just a little bit upset that I can't even get a comment out of him. I've been a big fan of Saturday Night Live. Can you just pass that message on to him? Are you Eddie's mother? Are you Eddie's mother?
Interview this Eddie.
Are you Eddie's mom?
No.
How are you related to Eddie?
I didn't say I was.
Oh, please, just, okay, ask a question?
No.
I've been hunting Eddie down for weeks.
I know.
I went to the comic strip.
Yeah, and you got this all on camera. You're going to have this on Saturday night?
Yeah, I went to Saturday Night Live to try and find him. Hurley's I went to. I'm just trying to find him. Like, could you just get me like a few questions?
No.
She knew you too.
Yeah. One day Eddie will
I'll meet him.
Yeah. Well, John, you did it. And you got nervous speaking into that Bubble Hill thing, didn't you? All right. You got a little nervous. All right. So you stuttered a little bit. So what? That worked. And it seemed like Eddie Murphy's mom knew Stuttering John.
And she said, are you going to put this on Saturday night? Yeah. You know about the show and everything. Yeah.
And John totally ignored everything
Absolutely.
She said.
Something might be taken out of it because I think she says, you know, I think she says my name. I don't know. Maybe I'm mistaken.
Everybody says your name. It's on everyone's lips, John.
Listen, I'm sick of doing the show, quite frankly. If you don't want to watch, it's fine. We won't get any ratings. But quite frankly, if you're going to watch, I think you should admit it. There are some people who watch this show and don't admit it.
Oh, really?
There are people who can act like Eddie Murphy's mother. You think she admits she watches?
Oh, she doesn't tell anybody.
Yeah, that's right. You want to keep the show on the air, you got to send us your letters. You got to admit it to the ratings people. That's all that we ask you to do. Okay. Hey, by the way, write to us at the Howard Stern Show, 9 Broadcast Plaza, Secaucus, New Jersey, 07096. And we'll see you next week. All right.